Is that one of my colleagues? Let's see if he's all right. See if my colleague's okay. Yeah. Turn up the idle. Never like to let it low idle. You all right, Bob? Yeah, I saw you too.
Well, how you doing?
Good, yourself?
What
happened to your leak? Coolant? Or what's going on? You tell me.
I just had it out at the shop. They did a D-rate.
Oh, the D-rate. Yeah, it looks like coolant, huh? This one for him. Push on that.
They just put some new gaskets on this little
deer. Did you hit a deer or something recently?
I didn't.
Oh, somebody else?
Yeah.
Yeah. So did it go back to derating again, or what did it? What's going on here?
Yeah, my check engine light, man.
Oh, okay. Let me get the other side. You got it. Good on coolant. One of these has got to be the, wonder if it's a seventh injector. I had a check engine light yesterday, but it cleared itself. After treatment problem? Probably.
I haven't had any problems with this. Like I say, they just went through and cleaned out the DGF system.
Okay, so you, when they do that, don't they disconnect hoses and put it back on maybe?
Yeah.
Probably didn't tighten up a hose clamp or something. There's a main hose right there. That's probably where it's coming from. And these clamps are not the kind that you can tighten down. They're squeeze clamps.
Yeah.
There's that one. That looks good. It looks like that main one might be coming from. Hard to say. You're full. Yeah, you're good. Maybe it's just an overflow.
That caused the yellow light to come?
I don't understand. Did it derate on you again?
No, just the
light.
Yellow light come on.
I don't know.
I went ahead and stopped here before I got in the middle of the one lane.
Right, yeah, good idea. Hard to say. Probably a residual effect of having to take that hose off to do the DPF work, and they put it back on. They may have overfilled it too, and it's trying to recorrect the right amount. I don't know. Have them check the clamp down there. You got somebody coming out?
Well, I called Brokedown.
They'll probably send somebody out to check you out. And they could plug it in the computer and find out why that check engine light, what it means, what code it is.
Yeah, they did. Probably Peterbilt.
That's a Packard?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, okay. You don't know, how long you had the truck?
I started here in February, and I've had it that long. I've not had any issues. You're in the Marine Corps?
I was in the Marines, Semper Fi.
My son is. He's down in San Diego.
Oh, in a boot camp or in a...
Oh, no, Miramar. 10 years in.
Oh, okay.
He's trying to do whatever hoops he's got to jump through to get warrant on.
Oh, nice. Gunner. My radio doesn't get out very far.
Well, mine doesn't either, but I got one of those where I turned the truck off for a minute to see if that light would reset. And it takes my CD all the way back down to 1.
Oh, okay.
Half the time I forget to.
Well, hopefully Breakdown will send some local mechanic out here to you and get you, find out how bad it is. Probably just a bad loose clamp. You still got good coolant.
Yeah, either that or, like you said, they just overfilled it.
Probably overfilled it because they're famous for that.
I don't know where the overflow is.
If they had to empty that to... I don't know if they had to empty that to get to the DPF.
Oh, I'm sure they did.
And then refill it. I'm not sure how that all works. And they're famous for overfilling those suckers.
Yeah.
All right, bub. Well, take care. Look at this guy. Is that... Come on, give us a little room here. Now I gotta find an opening to get out. Let's get a running start at it. Back up a little bit. The common courtesy rule for trucking is to get over one lane for the broke down vehicles on the broke down shoulder. Now I understand it's one lane ahead, but come on. Okay, I want to get a little more. I'll get as much as I can because I'm kind of climbing a little bit and I'm heavy, 70,000. Shoot. Get a running start at this. It looks like right after this guy. Let's go. Let's go. And see how I give the guy extra room. I hope he's gonna be alright. I mean, that's a tough deal to be just starting out and break down and have to go to hotel rooms, this and that. When you don't have a lot of income coming in, just a tough deal all around. It happened to me last year. My truck, the first truck I leased at SWID, JCT broke down on me, and they get towed. They charged me $600 for the tow, something like that. Then I had to put him in the shop for 2 or 3 days before they could even look at it, and because they had a bunch of trucks ahead of me, and I had to sit in a hotel $60-65 a day waiting for a word. You guys got any answer today? Oh, we haven't even brought it in the shop yet. Maybe tomorrow. And you're just sitting there. You don't know, that's an unknown factor. How much money you're gonna bleed sitting in a hotel room doing, being somewhere you don't want to be. If you're gonna be sitting down, you might as well go sit at home. Downtime sucks. Uptime is where the money's at. And if you're gonna be sitting for 3 days, that's 3 days you can't sit at home, because you can't afford to go 3 days on the road and 3 days at home. That's 6 days down. So you got to sacrifice 3 days at home for the 3 days you were sitting in a hotel waiting for your truck to get fixed. No productivity. You might have to skip 6 days at home over the next several months to make up for it. The loss of productivity. I mean, it's just the way it goes. So, anyway, there you go.